be fresh, I rock well.
What's going on, y'all? I'm Julian Lockhart Miles, the executive producer of the Hip Hop Film Festival.
And I'm C.R. Caper, CEO and founder of the Hip Hop Film Festival. And
you're watching Rebel Minded TV. What's up, y'all? This is Uncle Ralph, Ralph McDaniels, Video Music Box, at Video Music Box, and you're tuned in to at Rebel Minded TV.
I started a show called Video Music Box in 1983, one of the first music video shows to feature hip-hop music on it, or hip-hop videos on it. I was working in 2016 with a young lady go by the name of Charlotte Capers, and she wanted to do a film festival, and she said, you know, can you help us? Can you get on board with us? And I said, absolutely, I think it's a great idea. And they made me the chairperson. I don't know, I never had a title before like that. So they made that up. And her and some other members of the group. And so I'm here. I knew it was a good idea because it would bring people together, like minds together. Anytime you bring like minds together, you talk about a particular content or a particular subject, it's always going to be good. So we're talking about hip hop, and we're talking about film, we're talking about TV and YouTube and all that kind of stuff. So it's a great thing. Well, current day situation with ownership and content on YouTube is not good, you know, because people put their content on there. I have content on there that people have blown up, put their own logo on it 3 or 4 times, not said that it was from Video Music Box, not said that it was what the director was or anything like that. They just put their own logo on it and hashtag on it and take content, you know, that's mine. So, you know, I chase people all the time. I go after them and say, look, you can't do that, dog. If you shoot something and I do that to you, that's whack. And I just say, be respectful to the filmmakers. But it's not even filmmakers. It's some dude out there that wants likes. Well, that's some dude out there that wants views. And that's what makes it really whack right now. So, you know, I don't want to put a film out and put, you know, my all over the front of it, you know, my hashtags all over it. I don't want to do it. I want the viewer who really loves music or loves video or whatever to look at it and say, oh, I really dug that, and I saw it into clarity without, you know, all these words on the screen trying to protect it from some bootleg guy who's gonna do that, and it's whack. So, you know, I'm gonna respect the filmmaker, respect the guy who was there doing it, whatever it is, you know, if it's you in a club, if it's you doing performance, if it's a freestyle from back in the days that you have, that somebody is like, oh, this is dope, this was when he first came out. You know, respect the cat who did it, and it, you know, you could repost it, but at least put the original posting on it.
What's going on, everybody? My name is Jules, the director, resident of Harlem. I'm here to support my good friend Charlotte, or rather, Sha Boogie's film festival, Hip Hop Film Festival. If y'all missed it, y'all missed it. What I'm presenting today is a short snippet, or rather sneak preview, of my film that I'm doing along with the family of the late, great Big L. The story is called Street Struck, the Big L story. This is about his life. You know, he's been in Harlem all his life. Me as a filmmaker, I chose to make this film because when Big L's parents came to Harlem, my parents were the exact first friends that he made in 139th Street. Now here it is, 40 plus late years later, I'm already a filmmaker. There weren't any other filmmakers in my block. And I was a great friend of Al, so I felt like, you know what? I gotta make this film, because he needs it. I think he needs to get the recognition that he was just, that's very just due. So So that's pretty much it. Big shout out to Rebel Minded TV. You're doing your thing. Keep on doing it. Peace. Throw the nails out.
For people that have a feature, if you do not have the funding, the great thing about being an independent filmmaker is you have to be able to morph and transition to whatever the financial situation is that you have to work with. So if you have a feature film and you don't have the money to fund the feature, put that on the side, but rewrite it and make it into a short. If you don't have enough money to produce a short, make it a teaser and put it up online and then do a crowdfunding campaign so that you can start and take baby steps and eventually get to that role and that place you want to with your project. Because at the end of the day, ownership is key, and that's why all of these film festivals are so successful, because it gives you the power to keep and own the rights to your project.
This is part of our responsibility, I think, you know, as teachers, is to go into the schools and talk to kids about being the next filmmaker, being the next producer, being the next artist, you know, and put a paintbrush, you know. And I go to like hardcore schools in South Bronx and Brownsville, because kids want to release something, you know, and I don't want it to be a gun pointed at me or anybody else. So we'd like to be able to come in and show you, look, here's a paintbrush, or here's a marker, and you can work with that, or you want to write something. You a writer, you want to spit something, whatever it is, here's an opportunity to do that. So we go to, and I try to catch the hardest kid in the room, you know, and you know, because they're going to be kids that are just artistic and they're going to join in immediately. But there's going to be that dude in the back of the head, in the back of the class, he got his head down, he's like, oh, Ralph, I don't care about that. And I'm trying to catch him, you know. Right. So, you know, and I think all the people here on the panel are involved in that type of work, because those are the young people that we'll see 10 years from now in a setting like this.
Because we don't have the other representations of who we are in as much abundance. And that's what we need to focus on. We need to focus on getting the, we need all of us need to put that content out there and make sure that we're telling the other real stories.
And that's how we did this festival. That's how we did the festival. Most, the majority of women in here are either content consumers, which is absolutely wonderful, or content creators, they're filmmakers. And they need that encouragement, because while they see it, sometimes it's hard to connect with people who are in the business that they can have access to ask questions.
Okay, whether it's a TV series or a movie, what I do, I view it. I have a team of people that view what you put out. If I like it, I show you the money. But when I show you the money, it's a one-time thing. So it's kind of like winning the lottery, how you want your money. You want it all up front, or you want the annuity? I'm telling you, as a black man, don't take all your money up front. I would like to buy your stuff if you have some. I'll buy it if it's good. But that's all you're going to see, one time. What he's talking about, I learned that the hard way, is the way to go, truly. So whether it's VOD, that's what you're doing, right? You're doing it, that's what I call, that's a residual value. It doesn't seem as glamorous up front, because I'm gonna be like, oh, I like it, here's 10 grand, or 5 grand, or whatever. You're like, I got paid. Yeah, you got paid, and you're done, and I own it all. Yeah. But doing what he's talking about doing, this way we're not educated, that's why I'm here. We're not educated, we all wanna get paid. We all want that Bentley, I know. But what he's talking about is the way to go, so.
If someone wants to purchase your content, that means that you're halfway there. So don't just sell out now to the first person that wanna come to you. You're on the right track. So if they're interested in you, again, you're doing the right thing, so you wanna hold off. Keep building your brand, because that's what all of this is, branding. Know who your target demographics are. Have the IP addresses, have your own analytics. So now when you're ready to sell and you're gonna be okay, and you will get the residual income, and that's the type that you can sustain from.